Now, what's the trouble with film photography? Is it really practical to shoot film anymore? There's a trend right now where the cool kids are acquiring film cameras and shooting film in most of the popular formats, including 120 or 6x7 cm, 6x6 cm, and 35mm. But seriously, in this day and age, is it really practical to shoot film anymore? As for me, I've been shooting film since 1976, and the last time I shot with a film camera was almost 20 years ago, and I really don't see the point in using a film camera anymore, especially as a professional photographer. Digital technology has changed the way I work, particularly, and I cannot deny that there's a convenience in the instant gratification when you shoot and your images are there, right there. The trouble with film is that you have to shoot in analog and transpose your work into digital. So basically, what's the point? And there is such a thing as a generation loss. The resolution on your prints and negatives will not be the same with digital. So there will be some sort of a generation loss to it. So seriously, what's the point? Unless all you did with film is make 11x14 or 16x20 enlargements, which you'll use for exhibition purposes. For me, there's hardly any point as a professional to be using analog or film because it adds to the steps, it adds to the process. Already, film is cumbersome because you have to carry the physical rolls with you. And even if you had 10 rolls of film, that's still around 360 exposures. So it's almost nothing compared to a high capacity memory card where at least you can shoot about 1,000 raw images. And what people don't realize is that film shooters like myself back in the day, we shot film like it was on tap. It hardly ever mattered to us. The way we shot film back in the day is the way we shoot digital these days. So we didn't care. It's not as if you're putting a price tag on every frame that you shoot. Back then, we just shot it. And we had motor drives on our cameras. I had the motor drive on my FM2 back in the day. So I was shooting film like it was on tap. And it's not the same these days. Which is why I appreciate simple beginner entry-level cameras for my casual photography. It's because they don't cost much. And the image quality that I get from old beginner cameras is, I don't know about the film look that people talk about these days, and as far as CCD sensors are concerned, I don't necessarily get to see that. But the point is, shooting an old technology, and in many ways it's lo-fi, so to speak, that's good enough for me. I don't really care. The point is, I don't spend a lot of money. I don't spend anything at all whenever I shoot with a digital camera. So seriously, it makes no sense for me to shoot with the film, especially for casual photography. Makes no sense. The only reason why you'll shoot film these days is, one, because you can afford it. You have to be a rich guy. You have to be sponsored to be able to afford the best film cameras and buying film stock and processing them and eventually making negatives or prints out of them. So seriously, there's no point in shooting film in this day and age. But what I do personally is shoot retro style, meaning I will shoot old lenses that have a physical aperture ring and a physical focus ring, like this 50mm 1.8 Nikkor AFD lens. It still has the traditional hyperfocal distance scale. It has the aperture ring. Although, what I do with this particular D40 is set the aperture in camera and simply use the focusing ring whenever I take a shot, because using an AFD lens on a D40 practically negates the autofocus feature, so everything has to be done manually. That, to me, is retro-style shooting. I don't have to worry about how much my exposures will cost. I can hone my skills practically because I can shoot unlimited number of exposures. I don't have to worry about processing. I don't have to worry about running out of film with a setup like this. And with my EOS R100, I use practically the same setup using an all mechanical manual focus and manual aperture lens. So it gives me that retro feel. It takes me back to the way I used to shoot, but at the same time not worry about the cost of film. So for me, it's a win-win situation. The equipment doesn't cost much and I get to shoot with a really compact package like this D40. It just brings me back to the fun of photography. It's not like I'm shooting for a client or anything, which is why, although there are people who shoot film and film cameras these days, they will really never get to experience how it was back in the day when we shot film like it was on tap. And it was. So if you're considering shooting a film camera, I will say it over and over, it makes no sense in this day and age. Simply because if you want to publish your work, unless you're putting it on exhibit, your prints or your negatives will have to go through a digital scan. And that's like a middleman process. So what's the point? You're shooting analog, but you're publishing in digital. Really makes no sense. Might as well shoot with an old digital camera. Then again, those are my thoughts on shooting retro and shooting film in this day and age. Again, this has been Direk Absabando, otherwise known as the Shutter Mania. Make serendipity happen.